Welcome back to the second part of the 2012 Channel Island Sports Awards here at Beau Sejour. Three awards down, but four still up for grabs tonight.
And that includes the main prize, Sports Personality of the Year. That is decided entirely by your votes. Time is running out to have your say.
The lines are open for your Channel Island Sports Personality of the Year. Call 0845 606 24 and add 01 for Jodie Bottrell, 02 for Carl Hester, 03 for Lee Merrion and 04 for Heather Watson. Terms and conditions apply. Lines close during the Sports Awards on January the 31st.
Yep, less than 10 minutes to go before the lines close and we will have a winner. There's been three winners already tonight. If you missed any of the action in our first programme, here's a quick recap.
The winner of the Aurigny Junior Team of the Year Award 2012 is Victoria College Prep.
Incredibly dedicated as a group of lads, put in huge amounts of work and effort throughout the whole year in terms of extra fitness, extra technical work, and they're just an absolute pleasure to work with and they deserve every little bit of success they get.
So many years in the sport, can you pick a highlight out of that time?
Well, yes, last January in Cardiff when the two boys brought their bronze medals back at the, the Commonwealth Championships, and that really has inspired them, and hopefully next August of next year, we'll be taking them to Glasgow for the full Commonwealth Games.
The winner of the Natwest Rising Star Award 2012 is Stanley Livingstone.
It's fantastic to be, you know, recognised as a sportsman of good quality. I don't know, I'm lost for words.
Welcome to floor level here at Beau Sejour. I've got made my way into our star-studded audience and found a couple of cricketers, Jersey's coach Craig Hogan, Guernsey's chief executive Mark Glatter. Craig, firstly coming to you, a word on your protégé up for the coach of the year tonight, Gemma Dunning.
Jim has done absolutely amazing work for us in Jersey with women's cricket and girls cricket, right from the grassroots level right through to the national team. And the work that she's put in, the girls are flying at the moment, and it's all due to Gemma. She's done a great job.
And Mark, this time last year, Guernsey were on stage as the team of the year. Looking to 2013, you've got to try and wrestle that inter-insular back, and your new director of cricket, Nick Pothas, has a job to do.
He certainly does, and that starts primarily in July when we've got the T20 World Cup over in Sussex, where we'll be playing Jersey as well. So hopefully we both end up in the final and Guernsey win.
I thought that might get quite a decent reception in this room, actually. Very quickly, gents, in a word, your winner tonight?
Gemma.
I mean, for the main awards.
I think Heather, but actually I've got a real soft spot for the equestrian, so I'm heading that way.
You're hedging your bets. And Mark?
Heather.
Brilliant. Mark and Craig, thank you very much indeed. Time to find out now which Channel Islands team will pick up our next award. Mark.
Yeah, this has been a really tough one. Very tough one for the judges to call, purely because there have been so many stunning team performances and achievements in 2012. Let's take a look at the nominees for the Clydesdale Bank International Team of the Year.
We're stepping into the unknown. But it was a challenge that I couldn't wait to start, and to finish off the season, getting promoted and winning the Premier Cup was a remarkable achievement, considering the amount of games, so many challenges along the way.
What can you say, really? Win the league, get promoted. Can't really ask for much more. Good performance in the Siam Cup. Although we lost, we're still kind of happy with the way we played and the heart and pride that we're showing there. I don't think you can ask for any more, really.
Definitely won't forget the promotion to the championship. You know, the boys stuck to the task and we never give up hope. We had a few losses and we was down towards bottom. And the boys' belief and ambition just driven us straight through for the rest of the year.
for the team Jets, it was just the most fantastic start to be unbeaten, especially going into the UK League. It was just great, and I think we'll all remember that for the rest of our netball careers. We've worked so hard, Linda's worked so hard, there's a lot of other people that worked really, really hard for us, so it's just nice for us to finally get that recognition.
Yeah, those teams have all had an absolutely fantastic year. To announce the winner, please welcome James Blower from Clydesdale Bank International.
Good evening, everybody. I'm delighted to be here on behalf of Clydesdale. I'm not going to bore you with a long speech because I know you all want to know who's win, so do I. So without further ado, I'm absolutely thrilled about this one. Guernsey Football Club.
The captain leads the way onto stage, Sam Cochran, the Guernsey FC skipper. Sam, when we spoke a couple of weeks ago, you said that this project, as it's called, couldn't get any better. Well, it just has a little bit.
Yeah, surprised, shocked, you know. When you look at the other teams up for this award, it's been an amazing year across the Channel Islands. And to come out on top and to win Team of the Year is an amazing achievement. But like I said, it's been a huge amount of work gone into the project. It's only very young, the whole challenge. But yeah, really proud. Proud moment for me, and you know, the boys have worked extremely hard. I'd like to thank our sponsors, you know, Sporting Bet, the main sponsor. Thank you very much for giving us this opportunity to compete, you know. And everyone else that's done so much for us, volunteers, right across the club. It's been an amazing year, and you know, this year's proven to be challenging as well, so.
And very quickly, Sam, it was a great raucous reception when you got the award. 1,000 people through the gates at Foots Lane every week. That must be great for you and the lads to play in front of.
Yeah, you know, like I say, we're extremely grateful for the support that we get. And the fans have been really, really loyal to us. And we never knew how many people would support us and follow the project. But it's proved to be, you know, appealing to people. And like I say, it's been amazing. And we're really grateful. And we hope it continues.
And another raucous reception as well. Ladies and gentlemen, your Clydesdale Bank Team of the Year, Guernsey FC. So congratulations to the Green Lions, and now time to tell you that the lines are closed. Please don't call, your votes won't be counted, but may still be charged. We'll reveal the winner in less than 15 minutes time. It's been such a difficult decision to pick a winner, as we found out while speaking to some of our local sports stars over the past couple of hours.
I've got my money on Heather. She's done amazing last season with it getting down to world number 40. And she's an inspiration to all sports. I know she's an inspiration to me, even though I don't play tennis. So.
I think anybody that wins a gold medal really deserves to be top, especially from the islands. I think it's tremendous. On the other hand, Heather's on her way up. The first girl to get into the top 50, now down at 40. I'd love to see her win it.
I personally think Lee Merrion should win. And the rationale for that is that I think anyone can run. So to be the best in that category, which something anyone can do, so he's the best out of 65 million people. For me, that's the reason why I think he should win it tonight.
Jodie should win, not only because she's my sister, which makes me a little bit biased, but she's also an awesome footballer, lived in Orland, which isn't the greatest place to live, and also really, really helps out the football community in Jersey.
Well, they all deserve to win, let's put it that way. But I suppose a gold is a gold is a gold.
A couple more guests joining me now. Deputy Darren Duckman and the chairman of the Jersey Sports Council, Hugh Raymond. Darren, tell us why this event is particularly special to you.
Well, it started I had a drink with Kevin Banner.
Always dangerous.
At the, I think it was Brian O'Reilly's in St. Sampson's when we were organising the Island Games. And I think he had half a lager, I had half a Diet Coke. And the rest is history. 6 weeks later, we held the first one at Springfield when the fire alarm went off. But 10 years later or more, it's a fantastic showcase for Channel Island Sport, and it's one that I'm still very proud of.
you a great year for sport in Jersey. Can you pick out a personal highlight?
It's very difficult to pick out a personal highlight because you've had individuals, you have teams, and it's being able to get everybody together. But the one thing that came out earlier on, even in the interview with Rob, was that we can't keep going with sport unless we have the volunteers. And I think one of the biggest things is that we need the volunteers to support sport. We also need the politicians to support sport. And I think that that's what keeps sport going across the islands. We all need it. We need to keep it going. We need to keep the youngsters active. And this is the best way of doing it, through sport.
Darren Hugh, thank you very much indeed. We're going to go back for another award now. Let's find out who is the Channel Islands' best boss. Mark.
Yeah, many successful teams means there are a number of highly talented coaches vying for our next category. Let's have a look at the nominees for Cenkos Coach of the Year.
The girls want to be the best they can, and you know, part of my job is to help them to achieve that. I know them inside out, and I know what makes them tick. I know what I have to do as a coach. And you know, it all comes together, luckily, on the court.
<laughs> 2012 has just been the most fantastic year for me. As a coach, I've developed so much. Everything I'd learned through playing and coaching in Australia, I implemented here. Like, more girls and women are playing now. And it's just, you know, the tournaments and the success we've had with playing against France, and then the success in Holland, it's just been a fantastic year.
You push the guys, you know, I'm well known for that. You know, to kind of see the kind of outcome that comes from that. It did take a while for it to sink in for myself. Straight away, I'm in business mode, and I went straight away, how are we going to compete next year and what are we going to do? And it's great to see that we have actually finished off a really good job. And, you know, the guys have got credit to themselves, and I enjoyed it.
When you come off the pitch and see the players high-fiving the kids all dressed in Guernsey FC merchandise, you know, it really makes you proud to see that, because at the end of the day, whilst we're in the sort of positions at the moment, if we can sustain this project and keep it going, it's for them as well. It's something for the kids to aspire to.
A lot of anticipation here for this particular one. Please welcome onto the stage Paul Matthews from Cenkos to present the award.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, distinguished guests. This is the seventh year that Cenkos has proudly supported the Channel Islands Sports Awards. And during this time, we have seen the standard of the nominees go from strength to strength. This is not only due to the hard work and dedication of our sportsmen and sportswomen, but also to the support and technical know-how of their coaches. So I'm very pleased to announce that the Cenkos Coach of the Year for 2012 is Linda Andrews.
I have a funny feeling you weren't expecting this.
No, I think when Guernsey got the football, I just thought, oh, Tony Vance will be that for this one, after all the hard work that he's done to get them where they were.
But what a team you've produced. To go through a whole season undefeated, it's an incredible achievement.
Yeah, we've had a lovely year. And, you know, I have the easier part to do. You know, they do the hard part when they're on the court. I've just got to sort them out and make sure I've got the right combinations out there. So, all credit to my Team Jets.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Cenkos Coach of the Year from Team Jets, Linda Andrews. And Linda will be hoping to lead her team to more success in 2013. On the subject of 2013, lots to look forward to in what is another action-packed sporting year in the Channel Islands.
come Doncaster. They are right on the edge of the Jersey line. They are over the Jersey line.
Post. Jamie Dodd has the header back across. It's Aurigny! It's a goal for Guernsey!
To our penultimate prize of the night, the Judges Award. This is for recognition of something really special and outstanding in 2012. As we've been hearing, there were a number of promotions for Channel Island teams last year, but one side's elevation lifted them above the rest.
In terms of ambition, getting as far as the best Jersey-born players.
We have massive talent on the island, so we definitely had the core to take us all the way.
Ben said to me his ambition is to get to the championship as quick as possible.
I was very confident about my own ability and I was confident that we had a lot of talent.
We had a few losses and we was down towards bottom and the boys' belief driven us straight through 2012.
Getting us here has been a great ride and you know the credit for that has gone purely to the players because we've got some tremendous players and that's why they've got to the stage.
The away win at Coventry was unbelievable to seal the deal of coming up to the championship. You have to pinch yourself now and again.
You said that a few years ago, Jersey versus Leicester Tigers or versus Newcastle, people would have thought you're mad. Being in the championship, any club is fantastic, but as a Jersey boy, to come back and play for Jersey means an extra bit to me.
I think taking them to the championship is a big achievement. I think keeping them here will be a bigger achievement.
Fantastic year for Jersey Rugby Club. I'm sure you'll all agree, ladies and gentlemen. It's over to our special guest for this evening, ITV's Ned Bolting, to present this award.
Good evening, everybody. We're getting to the business end now, aren't we? So the Judges Award for sporting achievement goes to Jersey Rugby. Don't stop, turn that up, take it higher. Take this mother up, start a riot. Don't stop, turn that up, take it higher. Take this mother up, start a riot. There's a glitch inside my system, rushing through my whole existence. Got me twisted, can't resist it. Something's flipping on my switches. Take them, break them, make them feel it. Mix it up and mass appeal it. Pressure is riding me hard. I didn't even know there was an award for this.
It's the first time a team's ever won it.
Well, we're delighted because, like with all the other guys, I spoke to Tony earlier on and the achievements of Guernsey football and what the Jets have done and Channel Island sport in general. I think it's a huge boost for what we can do and what Heather's doing and on the world stage and what Carl has done in the Olympics. And I just think that there's an enormous amount of talent in the Channel Islands. And if it's unearthed and it's given support by the government, by everybody else, then you can go on to bigger and better things.
Bill, you've put so much time into it. How much pride does it see you watch the boys go out against the likes of Bristol and Leeds every week?
Yeah, it is a bit unbelievable. We're actually now even hopeful that we'll stay there. We mightn't have been a couple of months ago, but things are turning around for us, going quite well. It's a huge, huge challenge. If we stay here for next year, we'll certainly change things around a little bit, get a few people to visit Jersey on a Friday night at 8 o'clock and make them feel very welcome. But we've sort of gone into the realms of professional sport, and that's what happens.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the Judges Award for Sporting Achievement for promotion to the Championship, Jersey Rugby Club. Right, time for the moment of truth. You have voted in your thousands for the 2012 Channel Islands Sports Personality of the Year. Four fantastic contenders, only one winner. Mark, who will it be?
Yeah, we're moments away from finding out, Rob. All of our nominees have achieved so much over 2012, but this would be a fine way to top it off for them.
It would be unbelievable. Like, I just don't expect it, and it's such an honour to be nominated. And if you'd said to me a couple of years ago I'd be here, I'd have been like, yeah, okay, whatever. But to actually be here, it doesn't feel real, and I'm actually going to go with the chance of winning it.
I didn't think it could get any better after the year I've had. To win that award obviously would make me feel so much part of the Channel Islands, and well, I know it would make one grandmother very happy.
Oh, it'd be a massive honour. I mean, Channel Islands are blessed to have so many great sports people, so, you know, just to be nominated is, sounds cliche, but it's a great honour, and especially Olympic year, when we've had three people at the greatest Olympics so far.
It's such an honour to be a role model for younger girls. I hope that I do inspire them and, you know, they do look up to me because, you know, I'd love to be that for them and to show them that they can do what they want to do.
The waiting is over, ladies and gentlemen. It is time to announce our Channel Island Sports Personality of the Year for 2012. And it's back to our special guest, Ned Bolting.
Right. I have in my hand a piece of paper. I'm nervous. Don't know what you guys must be feeling like. The Channel Islands Sports Personality of the Year for 2012. And thoroughly deserved, I think, is Carl Hester.
As I'm sure the more observant amongst you have noticed, this isn't actually Carl Hester, this is one of his closest friends, James. James, thanks very much for coming and accepting the award on Carl's behalf. I am delighted to say that joining us now, live on the line, is your new Sports Personality of the Year, Carl Hester. Carl, many, many congratulations indeed. Talk us through what it means to you to win this award.
that was actually more nerve-wracking than waiting for my score at the Olympics, I think, listening to who was going to win that award. Obviously, it's a complete honour, and to come from Sark, obviously one of the smallest islands, really is a huge, huge thing for me, and I think for the islanders there. And first of all, congratulations to everybody else that was nominated for that award. I know it means an awful lot to everybody, and I mean, for me in particular, obviously being part of Team GB this year, I know they'll be celebrating that award with me. So thank you very much to everybody who voted.
Carl, could the year have got any better? You didn't just ride a gold medal horse, you trained one as well, and Charlotte got the gold on Vallegro, your horse.
Yeah, no jealousy there, of course. Yeah, I mean, to actually be part of someone else's success is an extremely humbling thing. Especially, you know, when I've been doing the sport for like 20 odd years and somebody comes along for 18 months and tips me at the post, was quite funny, really. But I mean, I don't really know how to describe what I felt on the day of her gold medal. It was quite a difficult moment to be a rider and a trainer and an owner. In an Olympic Games, it's quite a
Carl, I hate to cut you off as you are on your winner in your prime, but ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your Sports Personality of the Year, Carl Hester. And that is all we've got time for tonight. Thank you so much for watching, for voting. Let's hope that 2013 lives up to 2012.
Yeah, what a fantastic year it has been. Congratulations, of course, to all seven of our winners tonight. Very worthy, I'm sure you'll agree, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah.
So that is it for tonight. Thank you for watching. Well done again to the winners. We will see you next year.
Good night.
thoroughly deserved, I think, is Carl Hester.